following the story all day of a Virginia State Police trooper shot and killed in Dinwiddie County. Master Trooper Junius Walker is the first Virginia State Trooper to have been intentionally shot and killed in 20 years, almost to the day.
Tonight, Mark Holmberg tells us about that 1993 case and speaks with Walker's former boss about his dedication to the job. State troopers are a different breed, more like military, like the Marine Corps, really, than a police force. That's why they're like family, a family they don't leave. Once a trooper, always a trooper. Semper Fi.
The state police training is once someone has been through the state police academy, there's a special relationship that exists for a lifetime.
It's a police agency with no boundaries, and thus many extra responsibilities. That's why Junius Walker was still rolling at 60, but he'd been talking seriously about retiring, said Massengill, his friend and old boss.
If you want to talk about a public servant, that was J.A. Walker. Filled with compassion, he knew when to get the pistol out and when to get someone to break. His biggest stature, his biggest heart.
Their heavy-duty training and professionalism has largely kept them safe, but they've still lost plenty in the family. Most of them struck by vehicles on the roads they patrol. Just 5 months ago, Trooper Andrew Fox was struck and fatally injured while directing traffic outside the state fair. And there have been, on average, one trooper killed in crashes or vehicle strikes every other year. But it's been 20 years since the last trooper was shot and killed. Trooper Jose Cavazos was shot in the chest 6 times by a speeding motorist in a stolen car, February 24, 1993. Another trooper died from gunshot wounds since then, in 1995. But that trooper, Henry Harmon, had been shot by a man he arrested nearly 30 years earlier and had been left a quadriplegic. The worst run of murders came between 1984 and 1987, when 5 troopers were slain. Today's killing is a shocker, one that the entire Virginia State Police family is feeling, bless their hearts. In Richmond, Mark Holmberg, CBS 6 News.